Hey y'all, it's Diane with Shawcraft One and my old barn door, and I'm getting ready to start the Christmas season. I know we still have Halloween and Thanksgiving to go, but in this community, of course, we all know that you have to do journals a little early for whatever holiday that you're making them for. So I will be beginning my Christmas journals next week. So I thought I would start it off with a bang. Every now and then I find a book that just brings tears to my eyes. Sometimes bad tears, but most of the time good tears. And this is one of those books. It brought wonderful tears to my eyes, and you'll know why at the end. But I thought I would share it with y'all to start off the Christmas season with a bang. So I've had this book for probably 3 years in my little tub of Christmas crafts, and every year I've looked through it and I've just thought, there's not really anything I want out of this book, you know, to make a journal with. And so yesterday I was going through my Christmas boxes, because I have three of them, you know, trying to get ready for the Christmas season, and I'm working on Christmas digitals. And I came across this book again, and I opened it up and I thought, man, I kind of flipped through it, just still couldn't find anything. So I had to take the dogs out to go potty. And so this was sitting on the table out on the screened in porch. And so I just started flipping through it and I started reading it, and oh my goodness, I'm so glad I did. So it's called A Christmas Cup of Tea. It is by Tom Hegg. Let me see I think it's a 1982 copyright. Yep, 1982. So it's been around for a while. So I thought I would just read this book to y'all and just share it with you. The log was in the fireplace, all spiced and set to burn. At last, the yearly Christmas race was in the clubhouse turn. The cards were in the mail, all the gifts beneath the tree, and 30 days reprieve till Visa could catch up with me. And though smug satisfaction seemed the order of the day, something still was nagging me and would not go away. A week before, I got a letter from my old great aunt. It read, "Of course I'll understand completely if you can't, but if you find you have some time, how wonderful if we could have a little chat and share a cup of Christmas tea." She'd had a mild stroke that year, which crippled her left side. Though housebound now, my folks had said it hadn't hurt her pride. They said, "She'd love to see you. What a nice thing it would be for you to go and maybe have a cup of Christmas tea." But boy, I didn't want to go. Oh, what a bitter pill to see an old relation, and how far she'd gone downhill. I remembered her as vigorous, as funny, and as bright. I remembered Christmas Eves when she regaled as half the night. I didn't want to risk all that. I didn't want the pain. I didn't need to be depressed. I didn't need the strain. And what about my brother? Why not him? She's his aunt too. I thought I had it justified, but then before I knew, the reasons not to go I so painstakingly had built were cracking wide and crumbling in an acid rain of guilt. I put on my boots and gloves and cap, shame stinging every pore, and armed with squeegee, sand, and map, I went out my front door. I drove in from the suburbs to the older part of town. The pastels of the newer homes gave way to gray and brown. I had that disembodied feeling as the car pulled up and stopped beside the wooden house that held the Christmas cup. How I got up to the door, I really couldn't tell. I watched my hand rise up and press the button of the bell. I waited, aided by my nervous rocking to and fro, and just as I was thinking I should turn around and go, I heard the rattle of the china in the hutch against the wall. the triple beat of 2 feet and a crutch come down the hall. The clicking of the door latch and the sliding of the bolt and a little swollen struggle popped it open with a jolt. She stood there, pale and tiny, looking fragile as an egg. I forced myself from staring at the brace that held her leg. And though her thick bifocals seemed to crack and spread her eyes, their milky and refracted depths lit up with young surprise. "Come in, come in," she laughed the words. She took me by the hand, and all my fears dissolved away as if by her command. We went inside, and then, before I knew how to react, before my eyes and ears and nose was Christmas past, alive, intact. The scent of candied oranges, of cinnamon and pine, the antique wooden soldiers in their military line, the porcelain nativity I'd always loved so much, the Dresden and the crystal I'd been told I mustn't touch. My spirit fairly bolted like a child out of class and danced among the ornaments of calico and glass. Like magic, I was 6 again, deep in a Christmas spell, steeped in the million memories the boy inside knew well. And here among the old Christmas cards so lovingly displayed, a special place of honor for the ones we kids had made. And there, beside her rocking chair, the center of it all, my great aunt stood and said, "How nice it was I'd come to call." I sat and rattled on about the weather and the flu. She listened very patiently, then smiled and said, "What's new?" Thoughts and words began to flow. I started making sense. I lost the phony breeziness I use when I get tense. She was still passionately interested in everything I did. She was positive, encouraging, like when I was a kid. Simple generalities still sent her into fits. She demanded the specifics, the particulars, the bits. We talked about the limitations that she'd had to face. She spoke with utter candor and with humor and good grace. Then, defying the reality of crutch and straightened knee, on wings of hospitality, she flew to brew the tea. I sat alone with feelings that I hadn't felt in years. I looked around at Christmas through a thick, hot blur of tears. And the candles and the holly she'd arranged on every shelf, the impossibly good cookies she still somehow baked herself. But these rich, tactile memories became quite pale and thin when measured by the Christmas my great aunt kept deep within. Her body halved and nearly spent, but my great aunt was whole. I saw a Christmas miracle, the triumph of a soul. The triple beat of 2 feet and a crutch came down the hall, the rattling of the china in the hutch against the wall. She poured 2 cups, she smiled, and then she handed one to me. And then we settled back and had a cup of Christmas tea. Still brought me to tears again. But I think that in this journaling community and in doing journals, we spend so much time trying to bring back memories for the people we make them for. Trying to give people that nostalgic feeling. And this book just really gave me that. So I wanted to share it with y'all. I hope you enjoyed it. I know it's a small, short video, but I hope it starts a great weekend for you. And I hope y'all have such a wonderful, fun weekend. And I can't wait to see you next week. And we'll start working on our Christmas journals. So if you have any comments or questions, you can leave them in the comment box below. Don't forget to like and subscribe for me if you will. And I hope y'all have a great Friday. Big hugs.